almost the shell of a woman after the surgeon's knife, and almost a year to creep back into strength. Till the dawn of our wedding decennial found me my seeming self again. We walked the forest together by a path of soundless moss and turf, but I could not look in your eyes, and you could not look in my eyes, for such sorrow was ours. The beginning of gray in your hair, and I but a shell of myself. And what did we talk of? Sky and water, anything most to hide our thoughts. And then your gift of wild roses set on the table to grace our dinner. Poor heart, how bravely you struggled to imagine and live a remembered rapture. Then my spirit drooped as the night came on, and you left me alone in my room for a while, as you did when I was a bride. Poor heart! And I looked in the mirror, and something said, one should be all dead when one is half dead, nor ever mock life, nor ever cheat love. And I did it, looking there in the mirror. Dear, have you ever understood?
Ye young debaters over the doctrine of the soul's immortality, I who lie here was the village atheist, talkative, contentious, versed in the arguments of the infidels. But through a long sickness, coughing myself to death, I read the Upanishads and the poetry of Jesus, and they lighted a torch of hope and intuition and desire, which the shadow, leading me swiftly through the caverns of darkness, could not extinguish. Listen to me, ye who live in the senses and think through the senses only. Immortality is not a gift. Immortality is an achievement. And only those who strive mightily shall possess it.
Your red blossoms amid green leaves are drooping, beautiful geranium. But you do not ask for water. You cannot speak. You do not need to speak. Everyone knows that you're dying of thirst. Yet they do not bring water. They pass on saying, the geranium wants water. And I, who had happiness to share, and long to share your happiness. I, who loved you, Spoon River, and craved your love, withered before your eyes, Spoon River. Thirsting, thirsting, voiceless from chasteness of soul to ask you for love. You who knew and saw me perish before you, like this geranium, which someone has planted over me and left to die.
If I could have lived another year, I could have finished my flying machine and become rich and famous. Hence, it is fitting the workman who tried to chisel a dove for me made it look more like a chicken. For what is it all but being hatched and running about the yard to the day of the block? Save that a man has an angel's brain and sees the axe from the first.